Who does not feel angry? Anger is a normal emotion. Expression of anger is actually equally important because unexpressed anger can lead to a buildup of resentment. Like, imagine a bubbling volcano which is hot and molten inside, and when it erupts, you know how much damage and disruption it can cause. So then, why do people say anger is harmful? Well, constant and frequent anger or angry outbursts can affect an individual's physical health. It can affect judgment, decision-making, and a general feeling of contentment. Often the way anger is expressed, it can feel intimidating, or people might feel criticized if you're angry with them, or they might feel, well, this was not justified at all. And therefore, it can affect relationships, be it personal or professional. Now, remember, people will always remember you by the way they have felt in your presence. Many times the spoken words are forgotten, but the emotions, they do linger on. Now, can you think of a situation that you might have been in where either you felt angry and somebody felt criticized, or vice versa? So in today's video, let's discuss anger, not just anger as a problem, but how do we use it to channel it, you know, more productively. Why do we feel angry? There are various reasons why we feel angry. Often it's the expression of fear, distress, displeasure, disgust, and sometimes even powerlessness. We are more prone to feel angry, say, for example, if we are stressed or hungry or tired. Now you might think, well, why doesn't she just give some quick tips to resolve anger or manage my anger? Yes, of course, I will do that, but quick tips are often a short-term fix. They may help you in the moment, but in the longer term, they're not going to come in handy. Self-discovery is a journey. It helps to build resilience, and it's better for good mental well-being. So let's start by you thinking about some of your triggers. What is it that makes you angry? Is it driving rage? Is it cues? Is it, you know, a particular person says something, just can't stand it, or a situation? Understanding anger is about, you know, putting together all the multi dimensions that come, or different dimensions that come together, including the biological, psychological, environmental, or social factors. And I'll talk about them, all of these factors. Let's start with biological or health related factors. Now, you all know that the limbic system in the brain deals with emotions, including anger. The amygdala, which is part of the limbic system, is particularly involved in processing of emotions and formation of emotional memories. Now, the amygdala receives sensory information, it interprets it. That triggers an emotional response, including anger, when it perceives a threat or an offense. The prefrontal cortex, on the other hand, is responsible for making considered decisions about how we are going to react to this information. So you can imagine in some individuals where there's a condition in the prefrontal cortex, they will be more predisposed to feeling angry. And sometimes it's just balancing the two. You know, there are chemicals in the brain, and these are messengers that carry the information between nerve cells. Now, some neurotransmitters or the chemicals like serotonin are associated with regulating mood or controlling impulsive behaviors. And low levels of serotonin have been linked to aggression and impulsivity, which may not necessarily contribute to anger per se, but to the intensity of anger, because they are affecting the emotions. Hormones like adrenaline and cortisol, they are released by the body in response to stress or perceived threats. Now, these hormones, they activate the fight or flight response, which prepares the body for action. In certain situations, this physiological response can manifest as anger. So you can imagine where the body is preparing to fight rather than flight. It motivates the individual to confront or overcome the perceived challenges or threats. Genetics, of course. Genetics control our propensity for everything. The genetic variations, they affect the functioning of the neurotransmitters, receptors, of the enzymes in our brain and the body, how we perceive emotions, how we regulate them, and they can increase the likelihood of experiencing intense or frequent anger. Now, have you heard people say, well, my dad used to be angry, like I also have these outbursts. Hormonal changes. Many women around their periods or around perimenopause, they experience feelings of irritability or anger more than usual. Now, many physical health conditions like chronic pain or when the blood sugar drops, what we call hypoglycemia, that can cause feelings of anger because what the body and the brain are saying is that we are struggling to cope a bit. Now, while anger is not a mental illness in itself, it can be a symptom of many mental health conditions, for example, depression, anxiety, or post-traumatic stress disorder, or psychosis, where individuals may lose touch with reality, or emotional variability, or conditions that cause emotional variability, where individuals may struggle to manage their emotions. Now, if any of these apply to you, start a 3-month tracker because it might help you identify if your anger is linked to any of these biological factors. Now, note that while biological factors, they do contribute to our experience of anger, they won't fully determine our emotional response because I told you about the multi-dimensions, right? So psychological factors, like what we learn through our growing up years, the cognitive processes, our coping strategies, and then in addition to that, the environmental factors, what's happening around us, they all significantly influence how we feel angry or how we express it or how we indeed regulate ourselves in expression of anger. So let's talk about the second factor, which is psychological. Now, you know that I explained the concept of the mind lens or the prism through which we view the world. I explained that the thickness of the lens equates to the biology and genetics, and the curvatures are our experiences, mainly during growing up years. So let me give you some examples. Think about Phil. He always saw his father shouting due to anger, and this kept everyone in the family quiet. So, well, of course, you know, naturally he grew up thinking that it's okay to express anger by shouting. He never learned to understand and manage his angry feelings in a productive way. And this became his behavior until he sought help. Let's take another example, Jill, who's on the other end of the spectrum, okay? Now, when she was younger, she was always punished for throwing tantrums due to anger. So she wouldn't express her anger anymore because she didn't want to be told off, and she would get quite overwhelmed and she would walk away from the situation, which meant she would either remove the situation or remove herself from the situation, which meant she became conflict avoidant, and this left her quite alone. She only realized it when she reflected on it. The other aspect of the mind lens is the chips or the traumas. Okay, now imagine Adele, who grew up with quite a few racist comments in school. And they affected her quite significantly. She was very professional and very attractive young woman at work. She went through a competitive process for a promotion, did not get it. That left her extremely angry. But it was only through recognizing and self-reflection she understood that the process at work had been fair on this occasion. But the chip on her mind lens had affected how she was experiencing things, and her anger was more about the past. Similarly, many traumas of the past, when unresolved, they can leave these chips on the mind lens that affect the different emotions and affect why is it happening. Like, we might be jumping to conclusions or catastrophizing or making assumptions, and what happens then is that the emotion of anger can be misplaced. In these situations, it helps to just stop and ask, what is the anger about? What does it represent? Okay, factor number three, environmental or circumstances. Now, we know that life is not the same every day. You know, there are many situations where anger is justified. It is part of life, you know, grief, loss, breakup of relationships. We do think about, why me? You know, well, if I should have done this, they should have done this. Anger is part of the normal process in these situations. Sometimes it is a manifestation of lack of control or hopelessness. You know, Can you imagine watching events on television that you really feel disgust for and they make you feel angry? It could be war, violence, crime. And often it's our psychological makeup and past experiences, they play a part in this as well. Other factors, the other circumstantial factors like stress can be a trigger for anger when we feel overwhelmed. You know, if there's work coming from every angle, it can make us angry. You know, I'm just being done to kind of feeling. Another factor is our desires and expectations. Now, there is something about how we expect to be treated or looked after or be dealt with that can provoke the emotions of anger. Now, if we are impulsive, or indeed if we feel entitled, we feel angry easily. Feelings of injustice, betrayal, in situations where, you know, sometimes you feel, I just didn't get a fair deal here. They can trigger feelings of anger. And of course, the threshold varies. If we have black and white thinking, then of course the threshold for anger will be different to someone who can see shades of gray. Can you imagine waiting on the phone with customer services for an hour, waiting for someone to answer your call? How does that make you feel? Another factor is substances like alcohol or recreational drugs. They can make people feel quite angry. Now, I told you about the prefrontal cortex, and alcohol and these substances can affect the impulse control in the prefrontal cortex. They reduce inhibition, self-control, empathy, and they change perception of experiences, and therefore they can affect cognitive functions. Question is, can we use this powerful emotion constructively and to our advantage? How can we channel our anger to be productive, use it as a motivator to bring about positive change in ourselves and in the world around us? Of course, I want to talk about it. I want you to think about it though. And I will discuss this and management of anger in my next video next week. Until then, I want you to complete this exercise and add your comments in the comment box. Think of the last time you felt angry. What made you angry? Anything small or big? Write down the biological, psychological, and environmental factors that came together during this event. What were the factors of your curvatures of your mind lens? Were there any traumas or chips? What did the anger represent for you? Remember, understanding yourself and why you feel angry is the first step towards managing your anger. So, watch my next video here, and if you want to learn more on how to live a more fulfilled life, subscribe to my channel here. And of course, if you've learned something useful, like it, share it, tell it to all the people you know. Thank you for watching.